please, the following films will be shown in black and white. Produced for general distribution was George Melford's The Poor Millionaire in 1930. The first film studio in the world was Thomas Edison's Black Maria, a frame building covered in black roofing paper built at Edison Laboratories in New Jersey. It cost just $637.67 to build in 1893. The first film ever made in Hollywood was D.W. Griffith's in Old California in 1910. It was shot in 2 days.
Thank you.
greatest number of takes for one scene in a film is 324 in Charlie Chaplin's 1931 City Lights. The first movie to use sound was a jazz singer, released in 1927. The first words spoken by Al Jolson were, "Wait a minute, you ain't heard nothing yet." The shortest dialogue script since the introduction of sound movies was written for Mel Brooks's silent movie in 1976. It has only one spoken word throughout, none. Iconic actresses came to the forefront of the movie industry. Names such as Grace Kelly, Ginger Rogers, Audrey Hepburn, Marilyn Monroe, Zsa Gabor, and Shirley Temple. Pink Panther film was made in 1963 and was closely followed by the second, A Shot in the Dark, in 1964. Seven more followed until 2006, when a remake of Steve Martin became the first Pink Panther film in three decades not to involve the participation of Blake Edwards. Jackie Chan was considered for the part of Kato, with Kevin Spacey and Mike Myers considered for the role of Clouseau. Today, more and more moving mistakes can be found due to being that it is often cheaper to leave them in than to reshoot, but more often because they are normally mistakes that went unnoticed. High levels of mistakes occur in Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, 296. Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, 289. Superman 4, 267. And Lord of the Rings, The Fellowship of the Ring, 262. In Pirates of the Caribbean, Curse of the Black Pearl, Will and Sparrow fight in a cart. Will sticks his sword in a wooden post, Will then falls and has his sword again. During the filming of Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Man's Chest, the cast and crew had to be evacuated to Los Angeles due to Hurricane Wilma.
My wife was terrible at keeping the house clean. it to Wright State. I couldn't find anything. It couldn't be that bad. Well, actually it was. I lost the armchair and only found it this morning down the back of the sofa.
I bet things have changed a bit in the 45 years inside.
Yes, apparently Milburn don't use horses anymore.
That's right.
Isn't the cart a bit heavy for the Milburn to pull by themselves?
No, it's got motorised.
An electric horse? What will they think of next? Can I have another teammate?
Have you been lucky enough to get a job yet?
I had an interview for a porter's job in hospital. I think they have a lot of ex-crims working as surgeons there, because all around the hospital they have signs saying thieves operating here.
Well, I hope things go well for you, mate.
Well, I did have a bit of luck. When I left jail, I put on the suit I went in with, and when I put my hands in my pocket, I found the receipt for shoe repairs.
You didn't go there, did you?
Sure did.
And did you really expect those shoes to still be there after all these years? What happened?
They said they'd be ready for Thursday.
The record for crashing the most police cars in a film was 30 cars in the Blues Brothers. The record was eventually broken when filming the sequel, Blues Brothers 2000. At the end of Blues Brothers, Steven Spielberg plays a tax clerk. During the film, when Dan Aykroyd starts dancing up the aisle of the church, in the back of the church, you can see one of the film crew run from left to right.
Do it right.
It's little known that Grease was actually a stage production first, many years before the film version was made. Many errors occur in the film, such as in the diner while Stanley and Sandy are standing in front of the jukebox, you can see the reflection of the overhead boom microphone in the chrome on the jukebox. When Frenchie is left with Val in the diner after showing her a bad hair colour, she switches off the light with her elbow, but doesn't actually touch the switch. In the song We Go Together, after the first verse, Danny sings the wrong words twice, with Sandy noticing and laughing the second time. In the scene where Danny and Cha-Cha receive the trophy, you can see Marty falls, and then she can't get up again because she keeps stepping on her dress. Circa 1955. Danny Zuko, the leader of the T-Birds, is joined today by Rizzo and Frenchie from the Pink Ladies.
Thank you.
Bruce Lee was so fast that they had to slow the film down so you could see his moves. Most stunts normally have to be speeded up to make them look good. The first Hollywood stuntman was Frank Hanaway. He was cast in The Great Train Robbery in 1903 for his ability to fall off a horse without hurting himself. The first Hollywood stuntwoman was Helen Holmes in 1914. Now for our homage to the great English comedy of the Carry On films, with our tribute to Carry On Doctor. When he told me I'd been promoted, and I swerved. And then he told me how much I'd be getting. I swerved again. Then he told me he was leaving, and I was going to own the company. I was so surprised, I ran straight into a tree.
So that's how you hit your head?
Yes, I careered off the road.
Thank you. on a horse and it died.
The owner of the horse, Miss Jones.
Oh, she's such a lovely old lady. She was so upset.
Why, she's just come back here now and given me a box of her possessions to sell in our fundraising sale.
I'd love to get her another horse, but I just can't afford it. My receptionist, she's into all this positive thinking, and she said if you want anything enough, you can get it. You've just got to put your mind to it. You can make anything happen. This is how she told me you can do it. She said to make a horse appear on the stage, what you need to do is to get a blanket and put it on the ground. Then, to make a horse appear, you have to go back and you have to turn 3 times. Then you have to shout for what you want to appear under your blanket. I want a real horse to appear under the blanket. Then, because I want a horse, I have to trot 6 times to the blanket. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then I have to neigh as loudly as I can and a horse will appear under the blanket. Right. Well, I don't believe it will happen, so of course it wouldn't work for me. But perhaps it will work for one of you. Now, she did say it works for 1 out of every 3 people. So I figure if I get 3 of you up here, it will work for 1 of you, right? Okay, so let me see. I think you, madam, you would like to come up.
Hey,
guess what?
No horses to see in our blanket. Well, I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, we didn't manage to make a real horse appear under the blanket.
But it nearly worked, because instead of one horse, we had three silly lasses. No doubt, and that will cost you 200 euros.
What? Just now you said 20 euros.
Yes, but that was before you demanded a second opinion, the lab report, and the CAT scan. And the lions eat them all. Then he looks at his next job. And the next job says, go and clean out the chimp's enclosure. So he goes into the chimp's enclosure, and as he enters, the chimps run up to him, throw their banana skins at him. Then they leap on his back, pull his hair, pull his clothes. So he gets his shovel and he beats them away. And before he knows it, he's killed them both. Oh no, what am I going to do? My boss and I have killed them. So he thinks, I know, I'll get rid of their bodies. And then they just think they've escaped. So he drags their bodies out. He thinks, oh, what am I going to do with these now? I know, he thinks, I'll throw the chimps into the lion enclosure. And the lions hurt them both. Then he looks at his next job. The next job says, go to the environmental centre and get the honey from the beehives. So he goes in there, takes Liz off the hive. And as he reaches in to get the honey out, all the bees come and start stinging them everywhere. So he gets them all off, gets his shovel, and beats them all to a pulp. Smashes them all down onto the ground. Then he scoops them up, puts them in his bucket, and you've guessed it. He throws it into the lion enclosure, and the lion eats them all. Well, he's finished his jobs now, so off he goes home. Later that afternoon, a new lion comes into the zoo, into the lion enclosure. And the new lion says to the first lion, what's it like here, mate? Is it all right? And the lion says, yeah, it's all right, mate. It's all right. So he says, yeah, but like, what's the food like? Is the food okay? Oh, yes, said the first lion. The food's great. Why, only this morning, we got fish and chimps and mushy bees.
Mushy bees.
Thank you.
especially high amount of mistakes in Austin Powers films, and makers claim that all errors were deliberate. In the 1997 film, when driving in Las Vegas, it is night. When out of the car, going into the hotel, it has obviously been filmed during the daytime. When unfrozen, Austin has clips on his ears. These are taken off, but he is later seen still wearing them. In Goldmember, when Steven Spielberg and Gwen Paltrow flip, the wig on the Gwen stunt double falls off. The mistakes are endless. Perhaps they should have rehearsed.
Thank you. actor's life for me. Hide the DVD, an actor's life for me. A wax mustache and a beaver, a hook, a hook, a car and a little goat. Hide the DVD, an actor's life for me. You rent the pair for Polly, you drive around in a coach of four, you stop the mile at the store, an actor's life for me. Hide the DVD, an actor's life for me. A high soprano, silver cane, a watch and gold for a diamond chain.
Segment of our show, after which we hope you'll be kind enough to take time to write comments about the show. The comments book will be placed on the front of the stage. The children look forward to reading what you have written. Now, sit back and take in a movie or two.
Thank you. Is it from Jumbo's?